Hey, welcome back. Today I'm going to take a look at the new stuff in Azure OpenAI Service. The most important thing about it now is that anybody can sign up. Previously, you had to beg Microsoft for access to Azure OpenAI Service by filling in a special form, and it was only open to partners of Microsoft. But now, anybody with an Azure subscription can get in there, which is awesome. Now, number two most important feature is that previously, to search for file information inside files, you would want to use the retrieval tool in OpenAI Assistance. And for 6 months, this was not supported. So here's a nice long thread of lots of people saying, please give us a retrieval tool option in Azure Assistance API, please, please, please. And there was no workaround unless you use the code interpreter tool, which was extremely slow. But finally, 5 days ago, they've just announced that the retrieval tool type was in the V1 version, and now they have access to file search, which is great, on Azure, finally. However, we look at the documentation, and we scroll down, and we look for some source code, we look for some sample code to help us figure out how to do this. And yet again, Python and REST calls. No C#, no .NET. Microsoft, please include C# and .NET samples in your documentation. It's your own programming language, please. Now, I have a sample code on my GitHub here. This is a sample project for querying information about a file, but this takes really, really long time, sometimes up to 30 seconds, because it has to use the code interpreter in the Assistance V1 API. So I've also got a video for the previous version of this repo. So in today's video, I'm going to update all the source code in this repo to use the Assistance V2 file search API. If you're going to find this interesting, please click the like button down below, which will encourage me to continue to fill in these documentation gaps that I find. Let's go. So here's the old version that used the code interpreter tool, which was extremely slow and could take 30 seconds or so. So the first thing we're going to do is change the SDK package that is used, and we're going to switch this over to version 2, or this top level package, which now appears to include all of the assistant stuff. Back over to our main program, and obviously it's going to start complaining. So there's a series of changes we need to make. So we'll start with changing how we create our top level Azure client, and we're going to grab a deployment URL that we have created earlier, and a key here, which obviously by the time you watch this video will no longer be valid. One major change we need to add is to call this get assistant client function, which is new. Now this is marked as super preview and for evaluation purposes, so we need to put that error in the bin. One tweak we will make as well is to very quickly grab the file name out of the args that we pass in. So the API has kind of changed quite a bit, so we can delete all this gumph and stick in a new version, which looks a little bit like this. So we upload a file here, and we mark it as used by the assistants. This is quite similar to before. The documentation talk about creating semantic indexes. Don't need to bother with that, because later it will just automatically create an index for this file when we add it to a message. So let's go through here and clean some of this up. That's obviously an error there. And all of this faff was around polling for new messages, so we could kind of get them onto the screen when they were ready. None of this is required anymore, folks. So what we can do is delete all of this. Very nice. So within our questioning loop, we need to create a message. So here's one I made earlier. The message creation options now has attachments, so we can refer to the file upload response file, and the tool here is tool definition create file search, which previously was not available, but now it is, which is great. So previously we were polling for stuff, but now there is actually a streaming API using a magic await for each, which I think is really cool. So once we get a message, we can start writing stuff out. So if we go, if the streaming update dot update kind is streaming update reason run created, we can type a little message in the console, console a write line, reading file. I think that's quite nice. So one type of update is going to be this. So if the streaming update is message content, is message content update, and it's not an equals, is it? It's an is, like so. We can then just write the text directly to the console. Content update text, like so. Now, this will write all of the tokens that come out of the streaming API as they come through. Let's do a little couple of quick tidy ups after that. So console.write line, give us a line break there. And this needs to be updated to Azure client dot get file client, leave file async. So here is our PDF. It's called geographyofjapan.pdf. It talks about the nice geography of this beautiful country. So what we can do, we can now run the application with .NET run and see what happens. Let's cross our fingers. At this point, it's going to be uploading the file to our Azure OpenAI service. And I think it automatically creates an index when we attach it to the message, but there's no code that does that, so we don't have to worry about it. So we can look at the file. We can maybe find something cool in here. Let's have a look. So let's start with something easy. So how about four large islands? So what we can do, we can say, what are the four large islands in Japan? Question mark. Reading file. That's a good start. Doop-be-doop. There you go. The four large islands in Japan are Honshu, Hokkaido, Kyushu, and Shikoku. Very nice. So we've got like a little source thing here. And there are some people complaining in even the OpenAI forums about what to do with this token. So you might want to strip it out. I will show you in a second how you can get a reference to the file as like a file sort of references thing, but we'll get there in a sec. Let's ask this one more question about the Chubu region of central Honshu is known as the Roof of Japan. Okay, so what is the Chubu region also known as? Question mark. Dippy doop. Let's go. Happy days. Let's go. Still faster than 30 seconds. Chubu region of central Honshu is known as the Roof of Japan. Look at that. Fantastic. So let's do an empty response here to clean up our files. And I'll show you how to add a reference to the file in the output. So if we want a reference to the file, we can stick it in here. So what you'll notice is that the content update has a property on here called text annotation, which I think is pretty cool. So if we can check that it's the right thing. So if content update dot text annotation, input file ID is the original file, which is the file upload response value ID. We can then write this out to the console, like so. Something like, put this in brackets, from space file upload response value file name, like so. Very good. Maybe another space there for good measure. We can then do an else statement here, like this. Save. Now let's run the app again and see if we get a nice little reference to our file in our output, which you could use for all sorts of things. And this is where probably Microsoft Copilot has the nice little references to your uploaded files. This is probably where it comes from. So we're going to run the app. Doop-de-doo. Upload that file again. There you go. Ask me a question. How many large islands in Japan? Question mark. Reading file. Same as before. There you go. From geographyofjapan.pdf. Well, that's what we want. That works. That's actually really nice and clean now. I'm really happy with that. And the performance is great. So if you found that useful, I've got the source code and probably a blog post in the description down below. If you could hit the like button if you like this kind of content. If you don't like this kind of content, press the like button 3 times, which is a special YouTube algorithm trick. Tells the algorithm that you don't like the video very much. I also appreciate all subscribers that continue to subscribe to this channel as it gets on a bit. Thanks for watching.